There's a kind of constant dialectic, as it were, between grace and effort.
Yeah.
And every spiritual tradition is a balance of those two. And when you begin to go too far in effort, it becomes a kind of doing, a kind of egoistic, muscular doing. And you go too far toward the grace, it becomes a kind of passive, dreamy kind of thing. Bringing those two together is the work of a master, the work of someone who understands. The person who goes into, it's one thing to get a touch of God in nature, but one then sometimes will see, it disappears. I don't live it. Where did it go? When that question comes in, then we're talking about method in a sacred sense. What the famous saying, I think it's Augustine, it may have been Ramakrishna, that God provides the wind, man must raise the sail. It's a beautiful thing, because grace doesn't come just, who are we to say how grace acts? But you can be sure there needs to be some preparation for grace. And roast chickens don't fly into your mouth. You have to yearn, you have to need something. Why? These imagery that God is suffering more than about our distance from him than we are suffering from our distance from God. And that is what you think. Something that hints to me is something of a new conception of God, to say something about God's need for us. Mm. Because in the academic forms of the scholastic things, God can't have any needs. He's perfect. Mm-hmm. That's it. Something's been lost in that way. Mm-hmm.